frigid? Is that what he said to you? I don't like that word. Forget about it and on to the next thing. Stay on your routine. Stay on a good routine. You told him how you feel about it. He heard how you feel about it. You know, walking around with a mug and a puss and a da da da. It's very unpleasant. Finish. Don't grow it into something. You know, it's not Jack and the Beanstalk, you know? Just forget about it. You think when you see these people marching down the aisle with their children and each one after another having children and becoming grandparents, that they never had a fight? You think their husbands never did anything stupid? You have to look at the big picture. What is the big picture for you? Not the small picture of today, the stupid thing that he did, that he doesn't want to apologize. Forget about these small things. Look ahead. You know why it doesn't pay to hold a grudge? Because nobody's worth it. Who's worth holding a grudge over? Nobody. Frigid? Who told you you were frigid? That is such a not nice thing to say. Is it hurtful? Yes. Is it true? No. You just need to learn how to separate your problems from the bedroom. And until you figure out what's destroying your intimacy, you're not going to be enjoying your intimacy. How are you supposed to warm up when you're bringing all that headaches into the bedroom? Separate your mind from your problems and don't bring it into the bedroom. You ever see these couples that are married like, you know, 60 years, 50, 60 years? Don't you wonder like how they do it? They train themselves to forget about it. They forget things. Either they really do forget it or they consciously make themselves forget it. Because what are you going to be mad about every little thing? It never pays to hold a grudge. Forget about it and on to the next thing. Stay on your routine. Stay on a good routine. You told him how you feel about it. He heard how you feel about it. You know, walking around with a mug and a puss and a da da da. It's very unpleasant. Finish. Don't grow it into something. You know, it's not Jack and the Beanstalk, you know? Just forget about it. You think when you see these people marching down the aisle with their children and each one after another having children and becoming grandparents, that they never had a fight? You think their husbands never did anything stupid? You have to look at the big picture. What is the big picture for you? Not the small picture of today, the stupid thing that he did, that he doesn't want to apologize. Forget about these small things. Look ahead. What is destroying your intimacy? You're bringing your problems into the bedroom. Separate your problems from your intimate time. If you have some residual resentment, well, it's gonna creep its way into your bedroom like a little cockroach. Either you forgive and forget, or don't forget and just forgive. But whatever you do, don't bring it into the bedroom. Because it's one of the destroyers. And before you can enjoy intimacy, you have to figure out how to eliminate what's destroying your intimacy. You know why I want you to forgive him? Because you'll feel a lot better. You're the one that's gonna feel better.